When we say the Iceman cometh, we mean Chief Meteorologist John Sessrich, who is live right out front of the building here next to a block of ice that used to be nearly 4 feet tall.
Yeah, he's the guy next to the kiddie pool. John, a block of ice in a kiddie pool says a lot about your forecast.
Uh-oh. And it just fell all over.
Did you see that?
Yeah, we saw.
Yeah, it broke into two pieces earlier, and it just, you know, actually, that actually felt pretty good.
John Sessrich out by the pool, out in front of the building. John, thanks for that. At millions of homes right now, of course, the air conditioners, they are cranking, and this intense heat is going to test the power infrastructure. News 4's Kim Quintero joins us live and local. She's at Falls Park in downtown Greenville on this very warm night. Kim, what's the threat of blackout or brownout this weekend? Carol, 9 days ago, Sergeant First Class Brad Thomas from Easley was killed in Afghanistan. His body arrived at GSP this morning. He is one of three South Carolina National Guardsmen killed as they conducted combat operations in Afghanistan. News 4's Sean Mazzarella tonight with what his service means to his fellow guardsmen and the community. All right, back now to our top story, the death of a law officer on the job in Lawrence County overnight. Tonight, the pain of losing Deputy Roger Rice is being felt well outside Lawrence County. Agencies big and small say when one hurts, they all do. Now to Spartanburg County, where the real law tonight is still looking for a fake cop. Last night, you may recall, we told you about a man impersonating an officer who attacked a woman. Well, tonight, we know he raped her. News 4's John Eby is here on the story tonight. John, they found her in a ditch, right?
Yeah, and deputies say after...
We're now on that severe weather we told you about last night here on News 4. It spawned a killer tornado that passed through York County. The National Weather Service calls it an EF2 tornado. It had winds of reaching around 135 miles per hour last night. It hit an area off Highway 324. Three people were killed. Five went to the hospital. Emergency management says it's the first time since 1926 that York County has had fatalities from a tornado. The twister damaged houses on just a few streets, by the way. Other people living nearby say they just got some rain and wind. A wreck in Greenville County left a high school student dead today. This happened around 2 this afternoon along Henderson Gap Road in Greer. According to the Greenville County Coroner's Office, 15-year-old Thomas Grant Cunningham was killed. The coroner says he veered into some oncoming traffic, overcorrected, hit a culvert, and then rolled the car several times. He was thrown out of the car. The coroner says he was not wearing a seatbelt. Cunningham was a student at Riverside High School. The man troopers say is responsible for the accident on I-85 that caused a traffic nightmare today is facing some charges tonight. Take a look at the view from Sky 4. It is not pretty. That's I-85 in Spartanburg County near exit 68, and that's how it looked for a lot of the day. All six lanes of traffic at a standstill for miles and for hours. Highway Patrol says a truck carrying pellets ran off the northbound side of the road around 10 this morning, hit the support beam holding up an electronic message board. Nobody got hurt, but the beams were bent badly, and the board was hovering over the interstate, so the Highway Patrol came in and closed down the northbound and the southbound lanes, and so the drivers just had to sit and wait it out. Angela, Carol, good evening from the White House. We did get a one-on-one interview with the president today, President Barack Obama, a busy man, but managed to give us a few minutes of his time today. We also got a tour of this very storied house back here, not the entirety of its 100,000 square feet, but some of it. We got access to the president today that a lot of the network reporters, a lot of the national reporters seldom get, if ever. In fact, take a look here. We have a piece of videotape. We want to show you what is sort of a boilerplate event here. This is Jay Carney's daily press briefing. We were there today. This happens every day. All the reporters crowd into a little room here at the White House, and they fire off questions to Jay Carney. Behind those walls in the cabinet room, though, the president and I talked today. We talked about his rural initiative, building private funding for small businesses, ideally that building jobs in those small businesses outside the cities.
And to take root in these rural communities that can help relieve unemployment and build on the success of the farm economy.
Some of the economists don't like it. It's not that they don't like it, but they're sort of saying ho-hum. Robert Reich called it policy miniature. What do you say to them, the critics who are already
I think that what we've seen coming out of the worst recession since the Great Depression.
Inside the cabinet room, myself and President Barack Obama earlier today. That interview, even before it happened, created some political headwinds, by the way, in the Carolinas. The GOP leadership, Republican Party leadership here in both Carolinas, came out with statements today before I even went in there and interviewed the president. They had gotten wind of it and said the president ought to come to the Carolinas and talk about jobs and ought to be busy creating policies that create more jobs in both North and South Carolina. Back here in Washington, D.C., the president and I also talked about gridlock. You may be familiar with it. Not a lot's getting done up on Capitol Hill today. There's a lot of animosity between the two parties. And the president has some things to say about that today. Here again, the president of the United States.
And I think that one of the things the American people want everybody in Congress to remember is you are not a Democrat or a Republican first, you're an American first.
Back here live at the White House, more from the president coming up here at 6 o'clock. We're going to show you the garden, and we don't mean in the Rose Garden. We're going to show you First Lady Michelle Obama's vegetable garden there on the south lawn of the White House. It's not very big, but the impact is quite big. They're producing 1,000 pounds of food out of that little garden every single year. More about that. We're also going to introduce you to a member of the Obama family hardly anybody gets to see in the flesh, so to speak. I'm not going to say his name out loud, but let's just say politics mean nothing to him. Governance means nothing to him. He's all about love. Angela, Carol, back to you. For now, Michael Cogdill reporting live at the White House. The Reverend Billy Graham once told me he watches us on WYFF4. We are honored. So with that in mind, this goes straight out to Montreat, North Carolina tonight. All of us here say happy birthday, Reverend Graham. Today, the Reverend Billy Graham turns 93 years old. We understand he planned to celebrate with a private family get-together there at home. He keeps busy these days, doesn't do many interviews anymore, and yet, as he lives in the afterglow of traveling to preach Christianity around the world, we thought you'd like to know how he's doing. So tonight, with the help of his eldest son, Franklin, a rare look into the world of the Reverend Billy Graham, then and now.
Well, I'm just grateful that my father has kept his focus. I have lunch with him at least once a week.
What a place to give your life to God.
He's talking lunch with a man who preached to hundreds of millions, knew so many presidents. You might imagine it's an almost presidential affair.
It's not Billy Graham, it's God.
Again, this is the Reverend Billy Graham's 93rd birthday today, but he and Franklin Graham don't shy away from talking about his death. Franklin tells us his father's funeral will keep the Christian gospel as its centerpiece, not Billy Graham. And the Reverend Graham has already chosen his epitaph. As you might imagine, that is a family secret, still a secret from you and me.
And a chance of an isolated afternoon or evening thunderstorm, especially for the mountains.
You know, if they won't let you in the kiddie pool,
you can't do what you can.
That's what I needed outside.
Yeah. You got a block of ice on your head. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
There it is.
That melted pretty fast. Did you notice
it's
that?
Almost gone now.
The heat from my head.
Nice going. John, well done. It is official down at USC.
It's going to dry out my contact.
Isn't that lovely? Yeah. Oh, no good deed.
No good deed goes on.
Michael trying to be professional. Yes. The Gamecocks athletic director.